past. In other words, when you are dealing with God and God is in control of the situation, the storms of life may rage, but you be encouraged. Folk may talk about you, but you be encouraged. Folk will try and tell you what you can't do, but you be encouraged, because the word of God says I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Oh yes, as Christians, the more we see God act on our behalf, the more we should learn to just trust Him. Let me tell you something, it's a sad occasion. It's understandable when new Christians, I'm talking about new converts, those who just came to Christ, I can understand when they show evidence of weak faith. They haven't spent enough time with God to understand the power of His might. But it's sad when the seasoned saints, those who have been on the road for a long time, when they doubt God. Let me tell you, God has a plan for your life. God has given me as the pastor a vision for our church. And if we are to receive all that God has for us, the only thing we need to do is trust Him. On doubting saints. Time has run out on folks scheming and plotting on the telephone. Time has run out on folks making excuses as to why they can't serve. Time has run out on folks talking about how it never happened before. Time has run out on folks doubting that God will bless a praying pastor and a faithful congregation. Time has run out. And so as I close, I'm reminded of another story that is told of a drought that threatened the crops in a village of Crete. The pastor told the congregation, there's nothing that will save us except for God's intervention. The pastor told them to go home, fast during the week, trust in God, and then come back on Sunday and pray a special prayer and a special litany for rain. The farmers and the members of the church all agreed. They went home and they fasted all week. Then they returned to the church on Sunday in great numbers. But as soon as the pastor came out of the study and looked at the congregation, he became furious, and he told the people to go home. Go away. I cannot pray with you. Why? Because you don't trust God. And so the members of the church began to protest. Pastor, what do you mean? We do trust God. We went home and we prayed and all week long, and we fasted all week long. And the pastor said, yeah, but you don't trust God, because if you trusted God when you came in here today, you would have had an umbrella. Y'all can catch it on your way home. God has made arrangements for all of our lives. And the question I want to ask happening, that he sent his only begotten son to die on the cross for our sin. It's God's divine timing that you are here in the time that you're here, the season that you're here. Don't you know you're not here by accident? Don't you know God don't do anything by circumstance or happenstance? You are here because God wants to use you. Yes, he is. Help me, church.